Notes. On Slippers. A very good film. I don't know why I didn't get more attention. Plenty of awards, because I thought it's very good. It has a stellar cast. Robert De Niro, Billy Crudup, Kevin Bacon, Dustin Hoffman, Brad Pitt. And there are a few, was it Mira Sorvino? A few more I'm showing it now. A few more I forget. And the story is also powerful. It's in a way along the lines of Payback, another film that I loved. I'm more familiar with a more recent version with Mel Gibson. A good actor and director. A pity he had those excesses on account of alcohol, maybe not just that. Probably not just that, a lack of, I don't know, proper education, understanding of the world. Actors in Hollywood and directors do have this problem. Many of them do a good job up there on the screen or on the set, but then in real life you are outraged by what they can say, do, act, the way they act. Thinking a week ago, I learned that a group of actors and directors from Hollywood sent a letter to support Jean-Luc Mélenchon, the candidate in the French elections, who is the opposite of Le Pen, but an extremist as well. If she is on the far right, he is on the far left. He wants to join the Bolivarian Revolution, but then people like those who supported, signed this petition, Oliver Stone and others, support already the likes of Castro. Well, they did when he was alive. Now they probably support his brother and Chavez, and it's unbelievable. Especially for someone who has lived through a communist regime for 25 years. Anyway, back to the film. Outrageous things happen. We're talking young people, children actually, boys, in their early teens, I'm thinking now, being abused. And the theme here is being abused by their guards, and raped, and of course there is another film made recently, Spotlight, which is revealing the magnitude of the atrocities committed by clergymen. So this is another look at abuse of children, this time by the guards. So there will be a few themes and issues here. One, what happens to these children? They're affected. They are psychologically sick after this ordeal. What happens in terms of payback? Here I will not say. I'm thinking there's no spoiler alert, and you'll have to look and see if those responsible end up paying. There are issues, moral issues. De Niro plays a priest, and then at one point there's a question if he will lie, which is a cardinal sin. It's terrible to lie, and swearing on the Bible in court. If you would lie in order to protect, to cover for two of these former teenagers who have been abused, and now they're adults and they're accused of having committed the crime. So will he lie to help them escape prison and sentence, hard sentence eventually, and compromise maybe his future absolution, his ascent to heaven, or will he just stay out of it? And Robert De Niro is in excellent form. It was the days when he had a chance to receive good screenplays, not like in The Intern, for instance.